Well, 1 year from tonight, we should know who Americans have elected as our next president.
Our choices right now include Republicans, Democrats, independents, men, a woman, and two minorities. And as WGN's Antoine Lewis reports, this year, the diversity of choices has created a different political debate. Antoine.
Stephen Allison, it started back in February with a remark from Delaware Senator Joe Biden about Senator Barack Obama. Biden called Obama, quote, articulate, bright, and clean. Now, Biden's words were a catalyst for discussions about black stereotypes, but it also opened a sore subject for many black Americans, namely, what does it mean to be black enough?
For the presidency of the United States of America.
Reverend Jesse Jackson, Carol Moseley Braun, Shirley Chisholm, and Reverend Al Sharpton, all African Americans who have sought the highest office in the United States.
My candidacy for president.
Yet when Illinois Senator Barack Obama announced his bid for president, it set off a national debate that escaped his predecessors, a debate about being black enough.
So part of the history this phrase has to do with what audience expectations are.
Dr. Ken Warren is a scholar of African American studies at the University of Chicago. He feels the debate surrounding Senator Obama's blackness is based in history, dating back to the 1800s and Frederick Douglass, a mixed-race, well-educated abolitionist.
The audience that they were trying to persuade as to the evils of slavery might not be as persuaded because he wasn't conventionally black enough.
For many African Americans, questions about being black enough extend beyond political perceptions. It speaks to a subject that is still very sensitive within the black community.
Some people just think if you act a certain way, you're not black enough.
I think people have certain expectations of what a black man or woman should look like, sound like, act like. These are often based on stereotypes.
What is it that is expected other than our being who we are?
It goes back to the days of slavery, when plantation owners placed dark-skinned slaves in the fields while those with light skin worked in the house. This led to prejudice within the black race and a perception that light-skinned slaves were superior.
My grandfather was a sharecropper.
Retired Chicago banker Lucille Conway grew up in Birmingham, Alabama. Though she's never experienced interracial prejudice herself, she knows it exists.
Sometimes you can see that another person of lighter skin will look at you with a brown skin, thinking that they are better.
Sometimes I was too black, and other times I'm black enough.
Former Chicago alderman turned radio broadcaster Cliff Kelly is light-skinned and knows the skin color tension quite well. Like the darker Lucille Conway, he wishes it would go away.
We need now more than ever to bring about some sort of cohesiveness because of the fact time's passing. You're either going forward or backward. We are regressing.
Case in point, this recent story out of Detroit. A black nightclub DJ offering free club admission only to light-skinned black women. The nationwide uproar caused the event to be canceled.
African Americans today, younger people, who for whatever reason don't know the history.
This march will not continue.
The history that the civil rights movement was based on equality and not the hue of one's skin. The history that as long as there is racism, reopening old wounds will not bring about healing for blacks or any other race, particularly in a country where the only thing that matters in its leader is who's American enough.
I think that we will get it together.
It does set me to think about in 2007 that we are still concerned about black and white rather than being concerned about mankind.
The problem here is that this discussion about whether or not Obama is black enough or not is largely a distraction.